Hey, you all. Oh my gosh, I feel like it's been a long time since I've been on here, but it hasn't been that long. I wanted to come on and say hi and break up your news feed for a little bit. Has this been like the longest year ever this week? I was just on a team call and our team meets on Zoom every week and I got to see everybody's faces and everything, so I was really excited, but I was like, oh my gosh, this Monday feels like it's been the longest week ever. So I wanted to give you guys a couple of quick tips. So I just did a team training on Zoom. We talked about a couple of things, and I want to, since most of y'all who are Facebook friends with me or who follow me on social media, a lot of you guys have your own businesses. Many of you are in direct sales or network marketing. A lot of you guys have your own businesses in terms of like online marketing, affiliate marketing, things like that. And I just want to break up the newsfeed for just a second and talk about something that I think is going to help all of you guys. So I've been in the direct sales network marketing space for a really, really, really long time. I know I look great for being 84 years old. However, I've been in direct sales for almost 20 years now. Actually, I think it's actually has been 20 years now. And one thing I will say is that this is not the first time there has been a big crisis that I've dealt with in terms of like going through something with the rest of the world and still grow a business. Hey, Tracy. Hey, you guys, if you're on live, say hi. I can't actually see you until you say hi, so say hello. If you're catching me on replay, just type replay. I always come back and say hello in the comments later. So I'm really excited to be on with you guys. I just was sharing on our team call, like there are three types of people, and y'all are gonna laugh. You probably are seeing them in your newsfeed right now. Like you're probably scrolling, and if it's not something about the coronavirus or what the White House is doing or whatever kind of updates or something, you're probably seeing these people in your newsfeed, one of the three people, or all three. So I want to share with you guys how to grow your business. Yes, you can grow your business during times of crisis. So it's actually pretty interesting. Like this actually made me go back and think. So I know that this is kind of on a way bigger scale for a lot of people, impacting a lot more people. But I remember being in direct sales during 9/11. I remember being in direct sales during the whole like crash of 2008, where pretty much everybody lost everything. I remember, and probably a lot of you guys have been working your business during times of crisis, right? So here's the thing. On your newsfeed, thank you, Tracy. So on your newsfeed, you're probably seeing three types of people right now, okay? I'm gonna tell you guys how to grow your business, because you can, on social media right now and off social media too, but also some things to look out for in your own self. And definitely if you are a team leader, you'll probably want to share this with your teams. Put it into your chats or your groups. This is for everybody and every company out there, because I'm seeing a lot of people doing these kinds of things. So the first person, okay, that you're probably going to probably not see much on social media, but who's probably in your team, and that's why I think it's really important that you share this with them, is that in times of crisis, there are some people who have money mindset issues, maybe they have limiting beliefs. Maybe they are in total freakout mode, quite honestly. I mean, let's just be real. Like, there's a lot of people right now in freakout mode. They're potentially or already have losing their income. They're worried about, you know, their kids being home for like the spring break that's never gonna end kind of thing. Like, they're in panic mode, okay? And rightfully so. I mean, everybody's got their own stuff that they're dealing with. And so there are probably people on your team, or maybe you, where you're in total freakout mode and it's like you feel like the world's spinning out of control and the last thing on your mind is growing your business. Like, the last thing you want to do is hop on a team training call or go to some Zoom that your team leader is hosting or hop on, you know, whatever. Here's the thing. In times like this, you may be tempted because it feels safe, or you're on overwhelm and you're spinning out, in freakout mode, to be really quiet about your business. Because for various reasons. One, you might just think, oh my gosh, it's like the last thing that I wanna do right now is build my business because I'm worried about how to get toilet paper from the grocery store. Okay, so That could be one thing, or it could be something super deep internal, and I'm not a therapist. However, I have talked to a whole lot of people in my time who struggle, like inside, they struggle with the thought of them prospering, making money, building something, growing during a time when other people aren't. I know that sounds, to some people, that's gonna sound so weird and so foreign. Like, what? Why would somebody be afraid of growth? Why would somebody be afraid of making more money when other people aren't? There are a lot of people out there who have limiting beliefs and money mindset issues where they, not intentionally, they will self-sabotage. They will stop showing up to build their business because fear, lack, limiting beliefs, they will stop. So if you share this with your team, let me know in the comments because I would love to give you a big, huge shout out and a thank you if you do happen to share this. I think it's really important because I'm seeing this happen a lot. I've talked to a lot of you guys. A lot of you guys lead very large teams. And we've been chatting back and forth about some ideas, like how to keep the morale up, how to keep people excited, how to keep it going, and stuff like that. And our team, we had one of the biggest Zooms that we've ever had in 4.5 years, just now, today, tonight, like just now. And I was chatting with a couple of you guys earlier about your teams, and some of you guys are having your conventions postponed or you're canceled altogether, and you're kind of like, how in the world do I build unity and thrive as a team and all that kind of stuff? And here's the thing. Some of your team members right now, if they're not showing up, if they're not getting on the calls, if they're not showing up on Zoom, if they're not posting on social media right now, if they're not responding back in your team chats and stuff like that, you guys, a lot of people are in freakout mode. And most people, whether they're amateur, you know, in their business, not saying that's a bad thing, just if they're new to building their business, they don't have quite their footing yet, they're not as confident yet. Some people are going to shrink back down and go dormant right now. And you as a leader have to be the one to help them out of that, okay, for their own sake. There's a couple ways to do that. You can love them out. Or the bad way is to like crack the whip and be like, why aren't you on here? Why aren't you in this call? Why aren't you in that chat? Like, dude, just don't. That's really actually the number one reason why people leave a company or a team is because they feel like, listen, lady, I already had a boss. I don't want another boss. You ain't my boss. Bye. Like, they'll just be out, right? So that's like the number one way to turn off your team member is to be like, where are you? Why aren't you there? Like, don't. Love them out. Why don't you check in with them? Why don't you just send them a message saying, hey, you were so missed on the Zoom. It was recorded in case you want to catch it later. Don't check in with them. Be like, I saw you weren't on there. What's wrong? Don't be like that. But do let them know, like, hey, did you see this was recorded? It was so good. I thought of you while we were on it. Oh my gosh, she was, you know, on fire. Oh, you have to watch it when you have some time, right? Those are ways that you can check in with people. The other side of leadership, though, is not always about the money. If you have team members who are dormant and silent right now, check in with them because you're a nice person. Check in with them because you notice something's off. Are you okay? You've been quiet. How's everything in your world? Are you just busy or do you want to talk? Be an ear. I'm not saying you have to be a personal therapist to everybody on your team. That's not what I'm saying, okay? That's not your role. That's not your job. But as a mentor, as like a shepherd, you can check in and just say, hey, you're missed. I wanted to let you know that we missed you. It was recorded. If you ever want to chat, I'd love to catch up. Listen, especially if it's somebody that you've personally sponsored or something, you really should be checking in with them, especially right now. People more than anything, during times like this, they need friends. They need a community. They need a tribe. Not all about the money and the grind and the hustle and da-da-da, all that kind of stuff. They need community, right? And so, especially if you are in an area where you are maybe even self-quarantining, or maybe you are under like a required, you have to stay in your home or whatever, you guys, more than ever, you need to be that person who's reaching out. But I will tell you, if you are personally in that mode where you yourself, you're freaking out, maybe you just got laid off, Maybe you're worried about money or food or how you're gonna get baby wipes for your kids or something like that. If you are in that mood, if you are in that mode, don't be quiet right now. You have to show up bigger and bolder and more confidently than ever. You have to show up. But there's three types of people. The one is what I'm talking about. They're quiet because they're in freakout mode. They're spinning out. They're like, ah, I'm not going to do anything. Oh, I don't really want to post about my business because that seems selfish and that seems self-serving. And, you know, I don't want to I'm making money and I don't want to sell my stuff because, you know, people are hurting right now and people are in crisis. And wouldn't that be rude of me to sell my stuff and da, da, da. And you're overthinking it, first of all. So you freak out and then you're like, oh, it's just way more comfortable to share a cat meme. So you don't post anything at all about your business, nothing. Like, you're on social media, but all you're doing is the safe and comfortable and boring things that everybody else is doing, right? You're not showing up big, bold. Now, person number two is like the opposite of that, okay? Person number two is like, buy my stuff because I sell health and wellness. I sell vitamins and now you need my stuff and you need my business. And don't you wish you had a network marketing business now, fools? Like, they're showing up like that, right? Like, they're showing up cocky. They're showing up rude. They're showing up like taking advantage. They're showing up to propagate fear and scarcity and lack and making people feel bad for having a job. Guess what, you guys? Not everybody wants a network marketing business. Not everybody wants to be in direct sales. Some people love their careers. I know a lot of people who they support and they encourage and they've been cheering me on for years, decades even, but they don't want to sell something through a network marketing model. That's okay. You guys, there's a ton of people who, God bless them, they love teaching. They love managing their restaurant. They love serving others in a retail store or doing whatever it is that they do. They love it. They love it so desperately and deeply. They are insulted when you tell them, see, you just lost your job because of this whole coronavirus thing. Bet you wish you had an MLM now. Like, ew, right? So person number two is kind of like, you know how like sometimes we talk about like when companies close or whatever, and it's like they're vultures, right? They're circling the highway because they think, ooh, that animal looks like it's dying over there on the highway. I'm going to circle and I'm going to snatch that body up, right? That's what they're thinking. I'm just being silly, but that's the truth. That's what they're thinking. The person that's acting like that, and I've seen somebody, thank God I haven't seen any from our team but I've seen these people like on social media daily now, and they're making these snarky, rude, awful posts about, ooh, y'all need to drink this drink and y'all need to pop this patch and whatever, da da da, because it's gonna cure this and it's gonna prevent that. First of all, that's not compliant. Second of all, that's just tacky. Like, you can't be promoting your product in a way that is abusing the situation at hand. Okay, can your product help people feel better, look better, whatever, whatever? Sure, okay, yes, right. But you can't be monetizing a global crisis to build your business, okay? That's kind of like the vulture thing. It's kind of, oh, I'm so sorry that your husband died, but you know, I'm taking applications now if you want to start dating again. Like, ew, right? No. So it's the same type of thing. Vultures, what are they after? So like when they're circling the highway, okay, because they know that an animal is on its deathbed. They're circling the highway. Why? Because of what's in it for them. They want to get fed. They're not circling the highway like thinking, how can I help this person? How can I save this person? How can I serve this person? I want to come from a place of generosity. I want to come from a place of love. I want to come from a heart-led, a servant-led spirit. No. They're coming from a place of, how much money can I make right now because that person's struggling? How can I win? What's in it for me, right? That's person number two. They're snarky, they're spammy, they're taking advantage, they're not coming at it from a place of caring. And you guys, a lot of people can sense it. you can sense it, can't you? When you're scrolling on social media, don't you have kind of a sixth sense to know when someone's talking to you about their business or about their product because they actually care? Because it's actually, you've had a conversation with them in the past, or you've been engaging on each other's posts, or you actually know them, or they actually care about you, or is it somebody that you have never talked to on social media before, ever, ever, ever? They don't even wish you happy birthday. They've never commented or liked or anything on your post. And now all of a sudden they're pitching their miracle whatever product or their business opportunity to you. Why? Because you just posted yesterday how you were struggling. People aren't stupid. Now, person number three is the person that I really implore you guys to be. And this is going to require kind of flipping the switch for a lot of you, okay? Because a lot of people who are new to their network marketing business, they don't quite have their footing yet. They're not as confident yet. They're not coming from a place of, I gotta get this person so that I can get to my next rank, or, ooh, I'm really struggling too if I show up and I get these people because, you know, they're going to buy more stuff because my product helps this, or, oh man, they're going to join my business because they need to make money. Now, if you're coming from a place of desperation, which quite honestly, a lot of people, when they first start their businesses online, they're in a place where they need to build it. You need to build your business. You need to have new customers on board. You need to attract new team members. Okay. But person number three is the person who says, yeah, that's gonna come in time as long as I do this the right way. As long as I show up consistently, I'm in it for the long haul. I'm in this for like the 30-year plan, okay? I'm in this for the marathon. I'm not in some get-rich-quick thing. A lot of people can make a lot of money fairly quickly with the back end, right? With the equity that they've put in behind the scenes for years and years and years, the relationships, the community events that they've hosted. I did Bunko forever, like outside of direct sales, right? So when I hopped into direct sales, yes, I popped pretty quick by doing home parties back in the day. But you know why? Because like I was a chapter leader for like mothers of preschoolers. I led women's ministries. I did Bible studies. I hosted community Bunko things. And then when I finally started to like attach my name to something, people already knew me and they liked me and they trusted me. So yes, they did business with me. If you're not in a position like that yet, you just have to play the long game. So yes, you could be in that phase of your business where you need to build your business. Like it's a need. You need the extra money. You got to grow this thing, right? But I'm going to challenge you. Zig Ziglar used to call it flipping the script in your brain. Like you literally have, and the more you practice this, the better you'll be at it. You have to learn to flip the script. Where in here, you're gonna be like, I need to get them. I gotta get them. I can get them on as a customer. I can get them on as a promoter because I'm gonna get this when they say yes. That's in here. That's in your head. You gotta get out of your head and get into your heart. And go flip that script and say, how can I serve this person? What do they need? Not what's in it for me. What's in it for that person? What can I offer to them? And here's the biggest, like I want to hold y'all's face and like speak this into you. The biggest thing that I can share with you guys right now is that right now in a time of crisis, the first thing someone needs from you is not your product. And it's not your business. Yes, that might be something that they need, but it's not the first thing they need. The first thing they need is they need to trust you. They need a friendship. They need, at the very least, they need someone that they at least know and like. Because otherwise, who are you attracting? Are you attracting people to come in based on fear? Are you dragging people into your business based on fear and scarcity and lack? Guess what? If you have to drag them in like that, you're going to have to drag them through it like that. You're going to have to fear them and intimidate them to do anything. Like, you don't want that. You don't want that culture. You don't want that team. You don't want that. You want to be a magnet. You want to be a positive force. You want people to come to you saying, I just want to be a part of whatever you're doing. I want to be a part of it because I resonate with you. You are building something I really want to be a part of. I've been looking for something like this. And oh, by the way, great product and a comp plan attached to it, right? So one of the things I love about network marketing is that we are contagious. Like, we can spread our own thing out into the world. And God, with social media, it's like this platform where we can reach people all over the world, you guys. So whatever company that you're in, whatever phase of business that you're in, first of all, try to be like person number three. Get out of your head of what's in it for me. Get into your heart of what's in it for them. How can I serve? Heart-led, servant-led. You've got to get into that space. You've got to get better and better at it. Every time you talk to somebody, just challenge yourself. As you scroll through Facebook, you don't even have to reach out. This is a cool, like, little challenge that you can do just for yourself, just to like work the muscle, right? And just to get stronger at this. As you scroll social media, think to yourself, don't go and message them just yet until you feel like you're going to go for it, right? But as you scroll through social media and somebody posts something, okay, that they actually wrote, not just sharing something, but they actually posted something. Maybe they're struggling. Maybe they're having a hard time finding baby wipes for their kids. Maybe they're pregnant and they're really scared. Maybe they just lost their job or their spouse just lost their job. Think, train yourself to see how fast you can think of how could what I offer serve this person. Or I want to take it one step further. This is something I actually really like to do. Just to flex this muscle, right? How can you serve this person? What's in it for them to be a part of what you've got going on that has nothing to do with your product and nothing to do with the income opportunity? What else could you serve them by introducing what you have to them? It's challenging. It is super challenging, other than your product. So if they're not, other than how they're gonna feel or look or whatever about your product, other than the business opportunity, what would being a part of what you've got going on, how could that benefit them? What's in it for them? I'll give you some clues. Culture, community, fun, personal development, a friend, a person that listens, a person that can take their mind off the craziness and the chaos. A positive force in their life. You know, if somebody's like super duper down in the dumps, odds are they really just need a big healthy dose of positive person in their life, right? What else can you do to serve that person outside of your company's product or the comp plan? It's a challenge, but when you start just training yourself to think like that of, this person does this, this is their situation, how can I serve them? Or who can I connect them to that can serve them? It's really, really cool when you immediately can start spinning out into thinking, I can serve that person, I can help that person. Oh, this person needs to know this person because they would totally become fast friends. Oh, I know somebody in Georgia. I know somebody who loves skiing. It's really cool when you can start to think of ways to serve by being a connector to either a person or a thing or a community or a tribe that somebody else can want out there, right? So here's what I want to leave you guys with is, if you are in network marketing, if you are an entrepreneur, especially if you use the online space, two things. One, you have to show up more now than ever before. Not to be the vulture, like posting, ooh, I bet you wish you had a network marketing business, or ooh, like y'all lost your J-O-B, like you're initializing J-O-B, like just over broke. Stop doing that. That's rude. Seriously, people love their jobs. There's nothing wrong with having a job. There's nothing wrong with loving a career. So stop abbreviating it like it stands for something other than just a place to work, to pay their bills, to support their family, right? A little soapbox there, but listen, you have to keep showing up. But the side note to why you need to be showing up online is, you guys, last time I went live, there were about 450 something Facebook friends that were online at the time. Like when you hit the go live button, you can actually see like how many of your friends are actually online. There were 450 last time I went live, like actively at the time that I chose to go live. This time there were over 1,000 people that said that they were online, that little thing said over 1,000 of your friends are online. This is what I want to share, and it literally just backs up what I want to share with you guys. The reason you have to show up more now is because more people are in a situation right now where they're scrolling trying to find news. They're scrolling social media But I will tell you, when you make a decision as a network marketer, as an entrepreneur, as a direct seller, as an affiliate marketer, whatever it is that you do, when you make a decision to show up and be that bright light, you're going to make a difference. Don't think that, oh, doing a live or making a positive post or something like that, that's just, people are just going to scroll. They're not going to like. I make a lot of posts that get relatively minimal engagement, but the messages I get, or when I'm in a conversation with somebody and they talk about that post, and then I go back and I'm like, you didn't even comment or like that post. It's very interesting, right? So I want to challenge you guys to stop thinking, what's in it for me? Who's going to like this? How many people are going to engage with? Stop talking about all that stuff. Algorithm, schmalgorithm. What I want to challenge you guys to do is show up and be a bright light. You are that positivity that, I'm not trying to be dramatic or anything. Okay, maybe yes, I am. That could literally save someone's life in a crisis right now. Do you know how many people are literally in a position where they're literally freaking out? What if your positive message breathes life back into them? What if your message of hope is that message that's like, you know what? Okay, back to center. I'm gonna get through this. What if? So be humor, be light, be uplifting, be inspiring, be that person that you need to see on your newsfeed. And it is not the vulture spamming and just what's in it for me, but they do have to see you on there. So you can't be person number one and be like quiet and dormant and only sharing cat memes or White House watch parties and stuff like that. Yes, be informative, but you can't just neglect your business. Okay, so be that third person. Definitely be that person that gets out of your head, get into your heart. What's in it for them? How can I serve? Who can I connect to? But show up. Show up in a way that is inspiring, that brings light, brings hope, brings positivity. Because a newsflash for you guys, that is literally how a lot of top leaders have built their businesses, is by showing up as that person who just other people just want to be in their orbit. It works. It really does. Yeah, your product is great. Yeah, the comp plan this and the fast start bonus is that and all that. That's great. The people who grow their businesses the best are the ones who just, they've got a tribe of people who are just like, I just want to be in your space. I want to learn from you. I want to do business with you. I want to be in chats with you. I just need more of you, right? Be that bright light, be that positive spot on people's news feeds, and let's go be our own spreading of positivity worldwide. So if you shared this, please let me know because I can't see it until we're done. If you caught me on live, say hi. I would love your feedback. What are your thoughts? Which person are you? Are you person number one, person number two, or person number three? I would love to know. And it's okay if you want to private message me and let me know, hey, you just gave me some huge aha moments. I'm going to change some things. Do it. You don't have to like publicize it. Just make some changes. If you caught this on replay, let me know that you caught it on replay so I can come back and say hi. I would love your comments, and I will see you guys on another video. I love you guys. Be well. Be safe. Stay inside. Wash your hands, and I'll see you guys on another video. Bye, you guys.